Hey YouTube, James here from Bangkok, Thailand. As always, I'm on my patio of the Astro Man Estates. Hey, I do want to show you guys something new today. It is really cool. It's the Breyer cigar, and it is from a great pipe maker by the name of Morgan Pipes. Chris Morgan is the actual proprietor and designer of this really cool smoking pipe that just happens to look like a cigar. And I gotta say, I met Chris probably a few weeks ago, and we've been chatting on Skype, chatting away about pipes and pipe making and the ins and outs of the pipe world and things like that. It's just been really cool to chat with him. Chris wanted me to try this. He said, James, I'm going to send you a Breyer pipe. Let me know what you think about it. Good or bad, just be honest and post a video. And I said, I'll do it. And I have to say, right off the bat, looking at Chris's website, I'd recommend everybody go there. It's www.morganpipes.com. I'll have links under the show more under this window, so everybody can check it out. His Facebook, and he has a YouTube page as well, so you'll be able to go there. But looking at the website, the pictures were just incredible. I kind of was like excited about it, looking at the pictures, and thought, wow, it's gonna be something cool, so hopefully it'll smoke as good as it looks. So what I want to do now is just kind of go over the aesthetics, and as a pipe collector myself, that's really important for me, is aesthetics, a sense of balance, proportion. It's different for everybody, obviously. Sandblast. That's a really nice blast, and it's polished carnauba wax. It's good to go. I'll start with a cap. You can see that's kind of rusticated to lock on that. Yeah. You can see it's rusticated to emulate like an ash. That comes off. Has this really cool O-ring on there that keeps it in there nice and tight. It's got his stamping on there. Morgan Pipes, the bit, vulcanite. I love the button on this. It's designed to actually rotate in your mouth like you when you're lighting a cigar. The other thing I really like, again, with that sandblast is that it sort of emulates a cigar wrapper, you know, the leaf wrapper on a cigar. It almost has gives it a realistic appearance as that goes. Chris also makes this in a smooth as well, so I might have to pick one of the smooths up just to put into the collection. So Chris has told me that he uses Mimo Breyer, which is some of the best Breyer blocks in the business. Mimo supplies a lot of the high-end Danish pipe makers, as well as some of the American artisanal pipe makers such as Chris. So you're getting good quality Breyer for sure. Kind of just wanted to go over some of the engineering on this too, and the internals. It's just beautiful stuff here. Chris has really designed something pretty unique. So you have basically the chamber coming down to about here. About here is just the actual draft hole, like in the shank of on a pipe. So it's just a little tunnel there. And then here it opens up. It's drilled out. See it in there or not, but anyway, there's a calabash here. This calabash does a phenomenal job of keeping the smoke dry and cool. It really, I think, is what makes this thing fly. It's works fantastic. I'm going to show you how to load this, how I load this with tobacco. Chris recommends using a fine ribbon and then chopping it up to get a really good smoke, but I've been finding I can just throw in, I like to smoke a Margate by Esoterica, and I don't chop it up or anything. Okay, I'm gonna show you how I pack this really quick. I'm gonna remove the cap, set that down. What I like to do, I use, I've been smoking Margate by Esoterica in here, which is, it's been smoking really well. I kind of like to get that in a row like that and just sort of feed it in, kind of work it in. Kind of spiral it in, twist it in a little bit. It's just like a pipe pretty much. It is a smaller diameter, the chamber, but it pretty much the same thing. I'm just tamping that down. I'm checking the draw to make sure it's not too tight, because if it's too tight, I'm just gonna start over, but I have the knack of that pretty much. This is the last bit that's gonna go in here. This is probably the only other tip I'll give on this. You can see that inside of that cap is probably, I'm gonna say maybe a quarter of an inch, but so you don't wanna pack it up to the very top of the ball right here. You wanna just go about a quarter inch. And if you do, just put the cap back on and twist it in, and that'll kind of put a nice pack on it. Get my charring light. Normally I let that sit a few minutes, but anyway, just wanted to say that the check tool, which pretty much everybody has as a standard tamp, if you don't usually get them free and whatnot, but I just wanted to say this fits in here perfectly. Anything bigger than this probably won't fit inside the chamber, so that tells you about the diameter of the chamber. It's just a little bit bigger than that. Now the smoking quality, which is what we want to know about, that's the main thing obviously. It smokes great. Like I've mentioned, I think it just does its job. The briar and the tobacco fuse together, it comes together as a wonderful smoke. I've yet to have a gurgle in here. It's a cool, dry smoke. Really amazing, which kind of, you know, for a novelty type of implement, smoking implement, it just surpasses, it's just awesome. Yeah, so. So as a smoking device, man, hey, it smokes great. I know it comes off as obviously as a novelty, but the proof in the pudding is how well it smokes, and you know, I can't deny that it's a great smoker. It smokes just as well as any of my other good pipes. It really does. The only thing I have to say is there's just a little bit of a learning curve if you're gonna smoke it indoors, like I smoke in my office when I'm working. And when I first got it, I was holding it down like this, you know, because it's different from a pipe, obviously, so it's in a horizontal position. If it goes down, if it inclines down a little bit, that fine ash can kind of come out and it'll cover your desk. But what you know, it's just like any kind of new thing, you have a learning curve. You just sort of keep the tip inclined up a little bit, and then no problem there. And like I say, if you're in a bar or a pub, you don't give a shit anyway, so, yeah, but, you know, it's just like a pipe you have to relight and tamp. It does tend to get a little hot wherever the coal is, that red hot cherry. It's a little bit hot to the touch, but that's only going to be on the upper half of the cigar. Back here, where the actual shank tunnel goes and the calabash, it's like room temperature. You won't even feel it. It's just wonderful. It's an amazing design. So you can hold it into your fingers. You know, I'm up here and it's not even hot. Up here it gets hot, but down here, it's no problem at all. Yeah, I wouldn't recommend smoking aromatics in it, but I think Virginias and definitely an English Latakia blend would just smokes sublimely in here. Just really nice. Yeah, so as far as the smoking qualities, it gets a pass. Again, the aesthetics get a pass. So we're rocking here. I also like to say that holding it in your, clenching it is really nice too. That button right there. I don't know if it's gonna focus, come on. Yeah, there you go. Really fits in between my teeth fine, and it just clenches perfectly. Just wanted to let you guys know, make sure if you're interested, check out Chris Morgan's website. Right off the bat, he makes beautiful pipes, so check out his pipes. He's an artisanal pipe maker. He's been at it for like 6 or 7 years, and you know, he's come up through the ranks, and he makes some serious pipes. Check them out. You'll see the Breyer cigar on there. Check the links out there, and you can see the pictures and how beautiful this thing is. I'll just show you one more time on that blast. It's just, that's just an awesome blast, man. I am just, I'm chuffed to bits, boys. I'm chuffed. I just want to say thanks for watching. I hope you guys are all doing well out there and having a great time watching the videos. So keep on making the badass vids, and I will talk to you soon. Also, thanks to the new subscribers, very much appreciated. Check out the Morgan Pipe, the Breyer Cigar. Peace!